Our hurricane season for 2025 is about to do a dramatic shift. Matter of fact, Invest 99L over here, you cannot take your eyes off, because 10, 12 days down the road, we could see it again as it gets further down the road as our gyre comes into play and our weather pattern come into play. I'm showing a dramatic shift to the west, and I'm still showing that it's going to start becoming active, potentially into the Western Caribbean, into the Gulf. So pay attention in the Gulf, especially for Texas, Louisiana, and Mexico. I'm seeing a westward shift. Now, this is going to totally change our weather pattern as well. We still have this cold blast coming through. Really, it's just a cold front. It's not an Arctic blast, everyone. There's no freezing temperatures. It's not even a proper cold blast. It's going to bring those 50s and 60s I've been showing you. But this is not going to last. This is like a fake fall, because it is going to come right back and warm up with a high pressure as we go into the beginning of September. Now, you can see we already have outlooks for formation into the eastern Pacific. So these tropical waves are still traveling to the west. And pretty soon, our weather pattern is going to allow them to come further towards that west northwest without being blocked by this trough, by any shear, and by any dry air. Now we have Hurricane Aaron that is leaving out the coast now and is going to become post-tropical. It's still bringing impacts at the moment. Plus Invest 99L. I'm still showing that this could do a quick formation, but it can also travel further down the Caribbean where it could form up into something late. This is right when we're going into our weather pattern change. So we cannot rule this wave out neither, or the next one coming off the coast of Africa. They're coming off southern now, and there's a lot of warm temperatures, and they're going to start strengthening up and going towards the west, and we're going to be in a different pattern where this is going to be a high ridge and not a trough, and it's going to be able to go towards that west northwest. So as we talk about the weather pattern that we're going into, you can see here from your Arctic oscillation, your AO, that after that cool air goes away, it's going to retract back. So it will be a fake fall, everyone. You can see this with the Euro as well. As that retracts back, the average is going to be right there on the neutral line. Just like the talk about this big La Nina coming. La Nina is going to be a weak La Nina, everyone. It's not going to be a strong La Nina. At the same time, you can see as we go into September, late August, that we're going to get out of that positive PNA, Pacific North American pattern, and we're going to stay around that neutral to that negative PNA the rest of the time. You can see this with GFS as well, agreeing together on this weather pattern we're going into for September. So for those that have never been here before, when you go into a positive PNA, this is where you get the high pressure built on along the west coast in western Canada. This is going to warm up, bring very warm temperatures. It's already forecasted and happening, while we have this trough of cooler air coming through for the central and the eastern US, also for eastern Canada as well. But when we go through the negative phase, this is going to reverse. This is going to get a high pressure building towards the eastern U.S. is going to bring back your warmer temperatures, and the trough is going to move towards the western of the U.S. Now, two things that's going to happen out of this, and it could be some helpful news, that when you get a high pressure building, it's commonly known, you're going to get circulation revolving clockwise. So any kind of tropical waves that tries to come off more likely will get pushed towards that western push. Now, whether this high pressure is over here towards the coast and this is getting pushed into the Gulf, or whether this high pressure is right over the Gulf and this is getting pushed into southern Texas, into Mexico, into the eastern Pacific, still remains to be seen. But this is the weather pattern that we're going into for September. And once again, this will leave a high ridge to help pull storms further towards the north. The question is going to be, where's this high pressure going to be set up at? And you see, we still have the same information from Global Tropics. So as we go into this weather pattern, they're going to try and form up into the MDR, the main development region right here. Then it's going to weaken down. It's going to slide under the radar, go out through the eastern Pacific. But as we go into the beginning of September, this is where it's going to start making that northward pattern. And you can see right here in this tan color that you're going to be above average temperatures, which means a high pressure, which means that big high jet stream, just like I showed you. So it's going to go towards the west, towards Texas, towards Louisiana, towards Mexico, and the eastern Pacific. So we're going to see a big shift to the west. Don't take your eyes off these tropical waves that's coming off the coast of Africa now, and Invest 99L, because these are literally 10 to 12 days away from reaching towards U.S. land if they were to head towards U.S. land. So it takes a long time for these waves to reach, and that puts us right at the weather pattern change. Not to mention what's going to happen when it does start going towards the west, because you see all of our temperatures from the western MDR into the Caribbean, into the eastern Pacific, and especially the Gulf. It is very warm waters, especially the Gulf. These temperatures have not even been tapped into yet, with the exclusion of a little bit below average that's going on right here from Hurricane Erin. But everything else is still sitting above average temperatures. Another factor that's very concerning, you see the intensification that Hurricane Erin got into when it went to warmer waters and it tapped into the deep ocean heat. Look at the deep ocean heat content that any tropical wave has to tap into, not to mention the temperatures of the sea surface. So whatever goes through these temperatures will start rapid intensifying. It all depends on how the shear is going to be. There's going to be some strong storms coming as we go through the beginning of September. Still showing as we stay in this pattern as we go towards the end of September into October, this is going to intensify even more. So you see this when you look at the latest weather models. You can see the weather pattern that we're going into. So here comes that trough while this system tries to form up into something into the Atlantic. This is by the GFS. While Invest 99L weakens down and goes under the radar. So here comes that trough of cool air. Just like I showed you yesterday, it's going to be a long duration event. It's going to last for about 10 days while this goes around the high pressure on this evolution with the GFS. Then as we go into the end of August, the beginning of September, here comes that high pressure rolling to the east. Here goes a jet stream going way far to the north. And this is going to allow these tropical waves start going to that west-northwest pattern. And you can see that the high pressure right here starts expanding. Our Bermuda high starts expanding as well. So that's going to help travel these waves long distance into the Caribbean, going right towards the western Caribbean into the Gulf while we get that high pressure set up. It could swing into the Pacific. Depends where this high pressure is once again. And it could move over further and swing this into the Gulf, everybody. Showing by the ensembles, you can see with GFS first, showing chances of something to form up into the Atlantic off that tropical wave. Then you have something that comes along later as we shift from late August into September. Here comes a shift of waves. So here's your high pressure right here, guiding everything to the west. Then it starts growing from the Western Caribbean into the possibilities of the Gulf and the Eastern Pacific as we go through the beginning of September. You can see the same thing on the Euro. Matter of fact, the Euro ensembles is showing that there's a chance for Invest 99L to come back. So as we go forward, you can see it heads towards the north. Invest 99L goes to the west, and it shows chances of formation. It shows weak, but it also shows strong chances. You see how that one weakened down, but the weaker ones started intensifying as we go towards the end of August into the beginning of September. Then here comes the possibility of that tropical wave coming back into the Western Caribbean as we get into extended high pressure, as we go into that weather pattern change from the end of August into the beginning of September, showing anything will be possible when we go through this phase, showing that our environment will be reaching some of its peaks, everyone. So for hurricane season, as we go through what we're going through now, all the way until the middle of October, this is where our strongest part of our season will be. Still showing our potential velocity anomaly, where you have favorable environment rising up with the blue or sinking air with this red. Now you can see that we're going through a sinking air pattern with that cool front and that dust that's coming through as well. So whatever travels further towards the west off the MDR is going to have problems, but also could form up later where we have a pattern of favorable environment going through our Caribbean, going through our Gulf, and going through our Eastern Pacific. This is right in the beginning of September. This is the first group of waves. Then we could have another pattern of some problems with either the high pressure or maybe some low cool front that comes just to the northern U.S., not any further than the northern U.S. So it will be unfavorable environment again, but it has pockets of neutral where still anything could happen in this pocket, but a lot of confidence still as we go from the end of September into October, that we're going to be in a very strong peak, a very much backloaded hurricane season. Please pay attention to this pattern because you're going to start hearing about it shortly because this is going to get very dangerous. And we are going to need to watch Invest 99L. You can see right here on the track guidance showing it could go anywhere north, it can go south. But when you look here with the European, you can see that ensemble shows it could go towards the Central American gyre, everyone, where it could still turn south or north later on. Remember, this would be 10 days away. This would be right when we have that pocket of favorable environment, showing it could stay a weak tropical depression and just stay under the radar. And then maybe later, try and form up into a tropical storm later. Now, it's still too far to get any idea from the deterministic models of what our outcome is, but we need to just follow this weather pattern because it'll start coming clear very shortly, everybody. You can see here with GFS, as that trough comes through, that goes around, potentially get Ferdinand out of that as that goes to the west, but we still get that tropical wave that travels all the way to the west, and it gets hit with the shear right there as we go through late August with the last piece of that trough coming through while all these tropical waves are going towards the west. Then as we go into September, look how they pull a little further towards that northward pull. Now on this run, it shows a high pressure starts building, but you can see that big ridge going further towards the north, which would invite anything headed to the north as we go from the end of August into September. Those that's been with me for a long time, you've seen me show this through so many hurricanes. Please pay attention if you're in the Gulf, if you're in Mexico, if you're at the Yucatan. Everything is going to start shifting to the west. And that is your latest update on what you can expect for the rest of this hurricane season, showing it's still going to be stronger as we go towards the end of September into October. That's pretty concerning as well, everybody. Thank you again for your time. Hope you have a very great day out there today. And before I go, a quick word from our Father, everyone. Psalm 27, 1 through 5. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even mine enemies and my foes, came upon me to eat up my flesh, they stumbled and fell. Though an host should encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war should rise against me, in this will I be confident. One thing have I desired of the Lord, that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. For in the time of trouble, he shall hide me in his pavilion. In the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide me. He shall set me up upon a rock. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. I'll see you again for tomorrow morning before I leave until the weekend. I will be back on Monday after that. I appreciate every single one of y'all. And remember, all glory does go to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life. And forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. Make sure you keep your eyes on Invest 99L.